It seems like there's nanotech already around us in all our devices and advanced electronics, probably even in our washing machines and microwaves. And now there's biomedical applications for nanotech. What, it all sounds futuristic now already, that's we're already using this stuff, but what is on the near horizon for nanotech applications? What's in the on the in the 5-year horizon? What's in the 10-year horizon? What things are going to be possible that are going to probably blow our minds?
Yeah, also a great question. And honestly, one that's almost hard to answer, because it almost would have been easier to answer that question maybe 20, 30 years ago. But the technology is just progressing what feels like exponentially fast. So what I think I can best say is that in the more near term, we will probably continue to see advancements in energy storage and information technology. So better computational abilities and better systems for both capturing and storing energy, utilizing the high surface area that you can get from nanomaterials and nanotechnology. And we'll probably also see better surface coatings for improved, say, protection for vehicles or other surfaces that are exposed to harsher environments. We'll see better means of making more robust and stable surfaces. And I would say in the longer term, maybe around the closer to the 10-year timescale, that's when we will start to see more and more advancements, I think, on the biotech and medical side. Because a lot of those things are actually being developed now, but they take a longer time to get out into the world, because those you have to do testing, get approval for, they take longer, where even if the technology is developed very rapidly, the means of testing and implementing it tend to take longer.
I think we're all waiting for nanoscale robots that enter our bodies and fix whatever is wrong. So can you tell me what the timetable is? Nanoscale robots that go in your body and fix whatever's wrong.
So when are we all going to become the Borg?
Yes, basically.
So nanobots are actually a really interesting case study, I guess, in terms of what people think of when they think of nano. Nanobots, the ones that I've seen, are actually quite simple, almost like molecular machines in a way. Like if you ever look at things like transport proteins, there's some really famous animations that people have done with those that are these like interesting protein structures that look like they're walking along a transport tube kind of surface, and they're like lugging along larger molecules that they're trying to transport. Those are the sort of nanomachines that actually already exist in our bodies, right? Like DNA that replicates in our bodies is being done by enzymes and molecular machines that are essentially nanobots. So I think what we'll actually see before we see absolutely newly designed nanobots, I think what we're actually going to see first is we're going to see nanobots that we already have that exist in nature being modified to do the things that we want them to do. So I think that's the new nanobot that we'll actually see.